Hi everyone, welcome back. It's me, Yanni, and of course, for everyone who doesn't know, I'm host this channel together with Diane. And today I have some easy farmhouse DIYs for you. So if you love farmhouse and you love easy and a little bit of chaos, you are at the right place. Let's jump into our first DIY.
So you see here what I will use for this DIYs for today, because I am showing you a little piece of wooden board. Of course, I can place my whole board over here. This is a little piece of scrap from that board, but if I have to carry it all over here, that will be a little bit too big. Some silhouettes are already printed out on my computer. This one is from the Christmas. I always save them because I use only the sides. I just going to cut it out, and then we are going to place it on a piece of board. Maybe I have an old piece of board. I will show you that in a moment. But you see, for this DIY, the most what you need is a piece of wood, and this one is I think two inches. Here in the Netherlands you call it centimeters. So I don't really know how you call. I think this is done for you is an inch, if I am correct. Now, like I said, some silhouettes of what you're going to make. You can make a bunny, you can make something for the spring. It doesn't matter. So you're just going to cut it out and place it on a board. That's what I'm going to do right now. So you see my prints are cut out right now. You see the Easter eggs and my three little tags. What I'm going to do right now is put them on a piece of wooden board. And then I will saw them out. So you see, I just found a piece of old piece of wood, because I always use everything I have in my stash. Of course, I have also a new piece, but I will use first this piece I already used for a couple of DIYs. So I will draw the lines around the Easter egg and of course around the tags, and then we will saw them out. So I did cut my tags already. Now I'm going to cut my Easter eggs, and then we are ready to paint it. So here you see the three tags I just also saw out, and you see here the two Easter eggs, the bigger one and the smaller one. What I'm probably going to do right now, place them on the top of this board. Later on I have to cut it on, I have to measure it out and then still saw it out. But maybe I leave it under here or not. It's a little bit where I want to have it. But what we're going to do right now, just give it, because this is wood and wood is taking a lot of paint and everything. So I think I do a layer of Mod Podge on top of it. So not every paint is going inside of the wood. So you need a lot of paint. So, and if you do a little layer of Mod Podge on it, then it doesn't go too much inside of the wood. And I'm debating if I am going to do this in the white color, or I have bought a new color, the gray. So I have to look. Maybe I'm going to try to look what the gray color will be. So a little bit of questions, but we are going to do now our painting. So I had a change of plans, like I always have. I'm going to start to do the bigger egg. Instead of painting it, I'm going to do it with some twine. I thought maybe that would be fun and gives a little bit more structure than every time paint everything. So I'm going to give this one some twine. And of course you can use any twine you want. I'm just starting on the side. Maybe some people start above, just what you get used to. And of course I'm doing the first layer just here, because he has to stand on his own still, so I have to be a little bit careful and just give the first row a little more glue. So everything will stay in place, at least, especially for the under row of your rope. I hope what I'm saying is sounding logical. At least I hope so. Because in my head it's always very logic, but most of the time, and you see here, I'm just doing it over here for the first row, and I have this one over here, and now I'm sure that afterwards he still can stand on his own, and now you can go further where you want. I'm just gluing it until here. So you see, now you have at least the underside is steady, that you can still glue it on top of a piece of wood or something else. That's what you want. And I'm going now to do a couple of turns, and then I show you how far I am. So you see already, I am already halfway my Easter egg, and I think he looks so nice with the twine on it. So I'm glad that I've changed my mind and I did some use some twine. So of course you can use any twine you want. I'm going to finish this off in totally, and then I show you how my Easter egg with the twine is looking like. So you see how this is how my Easter egg turned out, and I am not unsatisfied how it is looking like. Of course I need to get away a little bit of the glue threads, because you know, with a glue gun, it always gives so much glue thread, at least with me. So I have to remove that, but beside that, I really am loving how it's turned out. And what I'm going to do with this one is also a change of plans. I'm going to give this, do something with the glue of my glue gun. I'm going to try to give it a letter in here and some structure on top of it, and then I will paint it. So we will see how this will turn out. So you see here I have the little egg, and of course you still see a little bit of the lines I measured out, but don't worry, we will work that away. What I'm going to try right now, before I'm going to work with my glue, I'm going to try to find a little bit the space I want to use for making my word on top of it. I'm going to make him as wide as my measure is turned out. You see, a little bit like this, just a little space in between. Here I'm going to try to write it. Of course I'm going to use the word home, because that's a little bit easier to write. The letters are easier to write with some glue gun on top of it, and then we were just going to see if that will work or not. So I'm going to write here home, and then I will be right back. So you see, I did write home, and what I'm going to do right now is just with some glue, I'm going to try to make the letters also on top of my little board. I'm just going to try to write home, and just so this will be a little task to do. So I will do this the rest out of camera. You see here I have already the H I already did, so I'm going to do the letters, the O, the M and the E. So I'll be back when I'm done with all of them. So you see, I have now the word home on top of it. What I'm going to do right now, it was a little bit easier than I thought it was, so just really try it home, because like I always say, I'm always an amateur also, so I'm just trying something out. So just I'm going to do one line over here, one line over here, and then I'm going to do some line around the Easter egg, and maybe in the middle some little you can do also dots, of course. Maybe that's something to do, a little dots from glue, but first the lining around it and some little stripes over here, and then we are fit to go and paint it. So you see, this is how my egg turned out, and I did some dots on here, and I
have to remove a couple of the threads from the glue, but I am not unsatisfied. Like I told you earlier, how easy it is. So if you have even a plain decor piece or an Easter egg or something else for a sign or something you can make, just use your glue gun and you can really make the greatest things, because you can do anything. This even the words are really great to work with. Of course, I use I use a very easy word home, but of course, if you have a little bit more difficult word, I wouldn't know how that will be. But it works really nice. But I especially am looking forward to paint it and look how it is after painting. So we are going to paint it right now. So this time I choose for the creamy white. I told you maybe I would use the gray, but I still like, I think, a little bit old white a little bit better. So I show you a little piece, but of course I won't bore you with painting because I think you already know. And it needs already, I see, a couple of layers. So this is just a little bit how it will look like, but when I'm totally finished, I am back with you, because I won't bore you. So while my other piece of egg is drying, I was thinking about doing this little piece of board, like I said, to do under the Easter eggs, but I changed my mind because I wanted to stand on his own and not with this piece of board under it. So I took a piece of my from an old picture frame. I already have them for years laying around. It's just a very cheap backside of your picture frame, and I just measured out my Easter egg on top of here and just measured out, and now I'm going to cut the shape out of it so I can glue it on the back side of my Easter egg so it can stand on his own, because I like that a little bit better than to give it the wooden feet as under your Easter egg. So I like this a little bit better. So if you have laying around some cheap and old picture frames, just always keep in mind to save the backside, because you never know when you can use it from another DIY. So I'm going to cut this out first. So you see, I measured it out, and now I did cut it out with a little a little tool. I don't know how you call it in English, but here we call it an knijptang. So I just measured out, now I can glue it on the back side of my Easter egg, and you see, now he can stand on his own, and I do the little Easter egg in front of it later, but you see already he looks for me a little bit better than I do a piece of wood under it. So I liked it a little bit better. So when I had my, you see here already standing my little Easter egg, but I was missing something, because if you do in front of it here my little Easter egg, I think I am missing something from the Easter. So I did draw out some bunny ears and a little piece of his head. So I don't know if I will use it or not, but when I have my Easter eggs over here, maybe I am like a little bit of the Easter also over here. So I will paint this in the black color to give it also the colors coming back, which I am having for my Easter decor. So I will paint this black. I don't know if I will use it, but I always have it on hand if I need it. So just from a piece, old piece of cardboard, just draw a couple of two little bunny ears. So you see here how my little Easter egg turned out, and you just see how easy you can see home. I thought maybe you would never see it. Of course, second time I will do things a little bit different, but what I'm going to do right now, because I like, I think, a little bit better that I distress it a little bit, the sides which are a little bit thicker, so a little bit with the black. So, but only a little bit, not a lot. So I have to make sure that my brush is very clean, of course. So I don't get really not a lot of paint of it. So just
besides the pieces who are with the glue. And if I don't like it, I just paint it over again. But I'm going to try if I like the distressing a little bit, just pieces on the dots. And of course, the hope and over here. And the letters and a little bit of the O, the M, and the E, so a little bit from here to here, and the underside, of course, not to forget. And I think he is coming a little bit more to life now, so I'm very happy how he's looking like. So this is going to be glued on top of the bigger Easter egg. And then we're going to look if I like a little bit more of the bunny also with it. But we will see. So my little ears are black, like you see. And what I'm going to do, I have still a little piece of ribbon because I want to make a little bow on top of here, because the ears will come probably out of here. When I tried it over here, but it was not a great size. This is too big, and if you pull them, if you do them on the back side of the Easter egg, you will see he will fit quite nice. So I'm going to do a little bow over here. So I will make my easy bow, like you probably, when you follow me already for a little while, I always glue this on top of each other. Just doing this, just squeeze it, do some piece of rope, and you already have your little bow tie. So I will make the little bow. So for the second time again, I was keep holding such a great story to you, but nothing was taking on my camera. So you see here, I did my Easter ears. I glue them on the back side of this Easter egg. I give it my little bow, and I know there are better bow makers, but I love this cute little bow. Now I'm going to glue this egg on front of the other egg, but of course a little bit sideways, so you still can see the egg with the rope on it. And I really love that it can stand on its own with my picture frame. But if you like it better, just to give it a little piece of wood on the underside is also fine. Do whatever you think is right. I love that the use of the old picture frame, so it can stand on its own. So I will show you later how it will look like in my decor. So you see how my Easter eggs turned out, and of course I really like how it's looked like, and I truly like the neutral tones. But maybe I will do a little bit of color, a little bit of a flower on top of it. Maybe my favorite always in hydrangea, so maybe I do a little piece over here, but we will see. And the thing I would have changed the next time, because I never thought about that, because I have it in the Easter an egg and his bunny ears, maybe I should have done hop in place instead of home. But it doesn't matter. You always learn every time. So if you are going to do it, maybe you can do hop instead of home, but just what you like, and you can write anything of it what you like. But for now, I really am happy how it's looked like. And you see also, I did the backside a little bit in the black color, because when you see it on the backside, it's even also pretty. Or pretty, you don't look at the backside, but if you probably, you would have seen it, it's all now. At least it looks nice. Let us say that. So what we're going to do right now, you see, saw me earlier sewing this pieces out, my tags. And what I'm going to do right now first is going to paint my tags, and then we're going to my computer and we are going to make our own three signs. Because if you follow me already for a long time, you know I love to make my own little pictures. For now I do the black color, but if you like, of course, another color, if you like the white color, the yellow color, the pastels, the pastel colors. Of course, you can do that color. This is just my theme, because I will use this in my decor, but of course you can do whatever you want. This is just a little bit of inspiration. So I will paint this, and then we're going to my computer. So you see the text are drying right now, so I take you now along to my computer to make our own signs. So come along. So you see how eventually they turned out. I'm so happy with the little truck, and of course the farmhouse market and the little flower market. Of course I will cut this out, and like I always say, I use this color because I wanted to have it in my tea tray a little bit in the neutral tone, so I can go around with another color, because if I choose for one color, then I can change it not very easily. So that's why I took these colors, a little bit of the neutral tones. But of course, if you like it in the yellow, in the red, or in the pink, or also like I said here, in the pastels, just do whatever you think is right. I love this color because I can change it very easily in my display. So, but go ahead and use your own colors. You can do it with magic. It's everything is possible. So I will cut this pictures out so we can mod podge them on top of our text. So you see I cut the pictures out, and now I'm going to mod podge them on top of my text. So you see I did the first time I mod podged the tag, and of course I did the picture on top of it. What I'm going to do right now, let it dry and then do the second coat over the picture, the mod podge over the picture, over the picture, so it will seal the picture also on top of the tag. So you see here how the tags are turned out. They are even this time almost without wrinkling, so I am very, very happy. What we're going to do right now, of course we can do a little piece of ribbon inside of the little holes to give the tag a little piece of how do you call it, a little ribbon out where you can hang it. But this time I'm going to use some twine, so I'm going to turn it a couple of times, not a lot. I think maybe 4 times is will be enough. So I will do, and of course you already know how to make this kind of pieces for your tag probably. And what I'm going to do, because I want to give it also a little piece of my ribbon I use for this season, so I'm trying to get all 4 of them through the little hole. So I hope this will work. Yes, he is through it. But what I'm going to do is put them together and just give them a little glue at the end. At least if I do glue inside of my glue gun, that works most of the time a little better. So just do some glue
on it and also on the other side, so they will be sticking together a little bit. I just take a piece of ribbon and just glue it against the little wire, just turn it a little bit. And of course, when I remove myself from the glue, I just cut out the ribbon and just glue this piece of ribbon also around your rope. Of course, it is a little bit messy because you are under the glue, but at the end you will see it looks great. So just remove the pieces of glue. Now I'm going to give a little cut over here because I want to have them straight. So you see, now you have a little bit more of your own touch on your tag. So just a little piece of ribbon and I let the stripe come back again, which I'm using in my decor. So I will do all three of them. So I will be back when they are finished. So you see a little bit of my display I have laying down for you, just because to give you a little bit of an idea how you can use your DIYs I made. And of course you see here the two Easter eggs with the little bow, and of course I did a little pink piece of a hydrangea on top of it. Like I said earlier, maybe I should have done the letters, I should have done hop instead of home, because I made an Easter egg. So maybe if I do it again, I will do that another time. Here are my two bunnies I already have for a couple of years. I give them right now a bow, the same bow I use for this season. And of course I painted the carrots in the gold color. The carrots already have been in every other color you can think of, because I paint everything. So, and here you see my three tags I will use in my three-tier trade. I will decorate it in the next coming videos. So if you like to see to how I decorate my three-tier trade, I have a black one. So I hope you come along and see what I made for my three-tier tray. But you see, the tags are turned out so nice. And I love that you have a little bit of the touch of yourself on top of it, instead of the normal ribbon you can do, of course, on it. And I did it also with my banner I have under my little shelf. And you see here the farmhouse truck and the farmers market, and of course the flower market. And you see, this is a little bit how you can decorate it. And of course, if anyone wants to know, the pears I have from AliExpress, they are very cheap. I bought them 10 for, I think, only a couple of euros, the same as dollars. So if you like that, go on AliExpress. You find that the most cheap faux food, and also bakery stuff like muffins, donuts. If you like that, go on AliExpress and you will find a lot of things. So, but I'm very happy how my two DIYs turned out. So I am already back just to show you also when you're doing it without the pink hydrangea flower. I love how he is looking this way, because I have my whole decor this way. But I understand if you like a little bit more color in your decor, then you are already can do it with a flower, of course, and I can do it without. Of course, I use flowers, but most of the time not on top of my DIYs for this year. So, but you just saw you can do it with and you can do it without. But I just wanted to show you both ways. So these were my easy and quick DIYs. I hope you had fun watching, because it's always a little bit of chaos around here. I hope you enjoyed, and if you like this content, I hope you will consider subscribing to Diana My Channel. For everyone, we wish you all a beautiful, beautiful day. Stay safe, take care of yourself, and take care of each other. And we hope to see you in our next video. Love from Diana and me. Bye, everyone.